श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। The second chapter of Atmabodhopanishad is the language of silence. When we are silent, and the silence is because we are no more living in the relative world. See, sounds are many. And because they are many, we can classify them: good sounds, bad sounds, holy sounds, unholy sounds, soft ones, harsh ones. And then there can be choice. Choice is possible when there is more than one. Now, contrary to this, many or multitude of sounds is the silence. Silence is one. There are no different grades or qualities of silence. So when we discard the sounds and come to the silence, we are getting out of the relativity and entering the absolute. And when we thus enter the absolute, then what is our position? Our position is, we don't like any disturbance. See? Therefore, you must have come across many places, many ashrams. There are many ghosts there. Keep quiet. Observe silence. Condolence on God. Why? Because God is disturbed if you talk. So people go with all grave face, and then spirituality increases. But when we transcend both the sounds and the silence. So, among the sounds, there is a choice. In only absolute silence, there is no choice. So, lesser the choice we give to ourselves, happier we are. More the choice we give to ourselves, miserable we are. So when we come at this level of silence, but there also this relativity remains. Silence versus no silence or the noise. And therefore such people, they get disturbed over every small issue. Then we transcend the silence and abide in that which is supporting both the silence as well as the sounds. Thus, when we reach this, which is beyond the sounds and the silence, what will be the language? See? So that is the language of the eloquence of silence. Now, this eloquence of silence is the language used in this second chapter of Atmabodhopanishad. And here, the experience is put into words. In fact, no words can comprehend. Yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasasa. Wherefrom the speech and the mind returns back without comprehension. So this absolute is now indicated as one's experience. So when one is abiding in this absolute reality, this experience is said in this Upanishad only for us to get some glimpses. It can't be spoken of. It can't be put in words. Like, you know, Brahmananda, the infinite bliss. You can't quantify it. But the scriptures have to help the seekers. So, Taittiriya Upanishad says, what is Brahmananda like? So, we are told. See, if there is a young man, healthy, handsome, and he is ruling the whole world, where there is not a single opposition party, he has got all the health, wisdom, everything, and he has got the most beautiful and intelligent also wife, never nagging him, what will be the happiness of that king? Oh, that is one unit of human happiness. Apne ko to kuch bhi nahi. And then further, such 100 units of happiness, they are equal to 1 unit of Gandharva happiness. Then 100 units of Gandharva happiness is equal to 1 unit of the Deva happiness. Then 100 units of Deva happiness is equal to Ajana Deva happiness. Then 100 units of Ajana Deva happiness is equal to 1 unit of Karma Deva happiness. 100 units of Karma Deva happiness is equal to the Indra happiness. And 100 units of Indra's happiness is equal to 1 unit of Brahaspati happiness. And 100 units of Brahaspati happiness, he is not even comparable with the Brahmananda. Hare Rama. What we have understood nothing. Our mind is totally blown out. But we have to be told. In the same manner here, what is said, don't try to read it and then by heart it. Aham Brahmasmi, Aham Brahmasmi. Samajh kya rakha hai? Aham Brahmasmi. And this is not the way. Pragalita nija mayoham nistula drushi rupo vastu matroham astas astamitahantoham pragalita vegadisha jiva vedoham. Now this is the experience. What is the first? Pragalita nija mayoham. All my delusions are gone. We have delusions about 3-4 things. First, about our own identity, as to who we are. No, no. We may think I am good, I am bad, etc. Let go of it. First, moha about this. Then, the second one is about world. When we say world, exactly what do we mean? Then the third point that we are confused having delusion is the God. And the fourth one is about what is the meaning of spirituality. Here, Pragalita Nijamayoham, all my delusions born out of the limitations in experience are gone. Galita is not gone. Galita is dissolved. See, on the spiritual path, be attentive. Problems are not solved. Problems are dissolved. See? How it can be dissolved? In the relative world, there is no problem which can be solved. Because in the relative world there are two standpoints. And everybody is right from his or her standpoint. Nobody is wrong. And therefore, the problems cannot be solved. And in the absolute reality, there is no problem to be solved. So when we come in the absolute, all the problems get dissolved. They need not be solved. Therefore, this word, pragalita, galita dissolved. So all the problems born out of the delusion are dissolved. Now there is nothing to be seen. It is a result, it is dissolved. Further, nistula drushi rupa vastu matroham. So I am this absolute reality which cannot be compared with anything. It is unparalleled, invaluable. In comparison to the sounds, silence is valuable. Therefore, all of us are seeking silence and knowing. Because ashantasya kuta sukham. Unless we are at peace with ourselves, we cannot discover happiness. So here the teacher says, this is unparalleled bliss means whether there is a silence or the noise, it makes no difference. Therefore, nistula drushi rupa vastu matroham, I am this immaculate, unparalleled absolute bliss. Asta astivita hantoham, then all my ahanta, the wrong notion of I, is gone. See, the other day we told you, there are many I's. First is the Gauna Atma or the secondary I. Secondary I's are the mother, father, brother, sister, husband. Then the second Atma is the Mithya Atma. Mithya Atma means the body notion that I am the body. Then the third one is the Mukhyatma, the real self. This mother, father, brother, sister, they cannot exist unless there is a body identification. So they are based on identification with the body. Mithyatma, I am the body notion, cannot happen unless we are identified with the body. But this absolute self that we are, whether we are identified with the body or not identified with the body makes no difference. Therefore, astamita ahantoham. Now there is no ahanta, there is no I associated. Because pragalita jagadisha jiva bhedo. These three factors are now totally dissolved. So see here. When we say the sea is very deep and the waves are very killing, what we are doing is, we are looking at the waters and calling the waters as the sea and the waves. So what we have done? We have abused that water by two words, ocean and the waves, in the same manner. We are seeing Paramatma, but we are calling that Paramatma as the world. We are the Divine Self, but we call ourselves as Papoham, Papa Karma, Ham, Jivatma. And that Paramatma is not far away above the clouds, Paroksha, but that is our essential nature. Thus, the Jiva Jagat Ishvara, the soul, the world and the creator of this world, all three are one. Three friends. Because all of them are dissolved in this one homogeneous being. Therefore, where is the ocean? Be attentive. Ocean is in our mouth. ocean is not in the water. Where are the waves? Waves are in our mouth. They are only words. Because we are seeing the waters and calling it as an ocean. So where is this? Vacharammanam vikaro namadheyam mrittikameva satyam. Upanishad says, we are touching the clay, but we call it as a pot. So when we are lifting the pot, we are essentially lifting the clay. So where is the pot? In our mouth. Pot is only a word. See? Therefore, this Bheda, the secret of Jiva Jagat Ishvara is completely dissolved. When this happens, what will be our experience? First of all, when the world disappears, there won't be any burden of desires on our mind. We desire about something only when we take that thing to be real, not otherwise. Do we desire the quality of our shadow? Because the shadow we do not take as real. You know, sometimes the lights are such that our shadow looks to be very tall or very fat. Do we give any importance to that? Because it is not taken as serious, it is not taken as real. In the same manner, world means, be very attentive, world means a sense of otherness. See, this friends, enemies, husband, wife, property, poverty, that is not the world. World is a sense of otherness. And when the sense of otherness is dissolved as in deep sleep, what is the net result? Because there is no sense of otherness, there is no desire. Desire is possible only if we accept something as other than I. Therefore, when this division of Jiva Jagat Ishvara disappears, the net result is, there will be zero desire. First. Second thing, when the Ishvara, who was Paroksha, who was far away above the clouds, when this notion disappears, the fear complex from the mind will disappear. Otherwise, all the time living in fear. I don't know what should I do. Ekadashi has taken rice. I don't know what will happen. You know what happens. Whatever, go to hell. Straight away. Because on Ekadashi, you have taken rice. In the whole of Bhagavad, nowhere it is said that Bhagavan Krishna has taken chapati. Only rice. So if he is there, why not we go there? Therefore, this fearful existence will disappear. So, Ishvara gone, Jagat gone. When Ishvara and Jagat has gone, where is the place for the Jiva? So, what is the Jiva? Jiva, be attentive. Jiva is expression of the infinite through the limitations of the finite. He is called as Jiva. And what is finite? Finite is Jagat, the world, and the Ishvara. When both of them have gone, where is the place for the Jiva? Because these three factors, Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, they are mutually dependent. Like, you know, cricket. There are three factors involved. One is the batting team, other is the fielding team, and third is the umpire. So when one team comes and sees the other team, oh God, they are going to kill us. Better we go walk over. So when one team will walk over, will the other team remain on the ground? when the other team also goes, what will be the umpire doing there? Boom. See, so when the jiva disappears, there is no possibility of jagat and the Ishvara. When the jagat, the world disappears, there is no place for the jiva and the Ishvara. When the Ishvara disappears, there is no place for the jiva and the jagat. So when both the teams and the umpire goes away, what remains there? Ground. Ground doesn't go anywhere. That ground of relativity is our essential nature. Hold on to that. See, friends. Therefore, Pragalita Jagadisha Jiva Bhedoham Pratyaga Bhinna Paroham. I am that undivided, immediate, absolute self. Pratyak, immediate. Parak, other. So, pratyak, abhinna, undivided. Division is possible only in the finite. Infinite cannot be divided. And the division in the infinite is only imaginary, not real. Like the space is infinite, and in this infinite space, we have the division, north, east, west, south, four corners, totally eight, up and down ten, dasha-disha, ten directions. So where are these ten directions? They are only imaginary. Therefore here, the teacher says, pratyak avinna bhed paroham. I am that undivided, absolute, supreme being. Again, is no more separated from me, no more divided into. Vidrasta ashesha vidhi nishedhoham. And therefore, I am not bound by any do's and don'ts. These are such simple things. Once I was in Delhi, and my friend jumped the red light on my saying. I said, come on, go fast, man. You are in Delhi. Why are you afraid of the red light? So, we crossed. And the police was standing there hiding. He came out. And in Delhi, there is highest level of understanding. So, the police came and he said that, with receipt 500, without receipt 200. Out of that 200, 50 rupees go to me, 50 goes to the government of Delhi, and 100 goes to government of India. Clear. This is what is called as clarity. Without that, they don't get the position there. So when you are just talking, I said, Mahatma Ji, it is on my account that the road was crossed in the red light, so please take money from me. He said, Babaji, traffic rules are applicable and applied on the driver, not on the passenger. See the truth of life. If there is a doer, then there is a vidhi nishedh. Do this. When we are snoring away in deep sleep, can somebody tell, you can sleep there but cannot snore. And you snore. They wake you. Why do you snore? I was not snoring. Because the one who is awake, he is not sleeping. The sleeper is different than the awake. See, friends. Therefore, vidhinishedha, the do's and don'ts are applied only for those who have accepted themselves to be an individual. Dissolve the individuality, no vidhinishedha, no do's and don'ts. Therefore, there are two paths we can call. One is this ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य शूद्र ब्रह्मचारी गृहस्थ वानप्रस्थ सन्यासी दिस इज कॉल्ड एज वर्णाश्रम व्यवस्था सो दोज हु आर लिविंग इन दिस वर्णाश्रम व्यवस्था फॉर देम देयर आर रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस इफ यू आर ए ब्राह्मण इफ यू आर ए क्षत्रिय इफ यू आर ए वैश्य इफ यू आर ए शूद्र व्हाट शुड बी डन व्हाट शुड बी Similarly, if you are a brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi, these are the do's and don'ts. One path. Second is the path of avadhuta. Avadhutas do not fall in the purview of the varnashrama vyavastha. And for them, therefore, what they do or they don't do, there is nobody who can challenge. The sannyasi, he is supposed to be without marriage. And there is supposed to be. So there are varieties. There are married sannyasis also. Variants. These are called variants. So, according to Varnashrama Vyavastha, a sannyasi should not be married. But when somebody is following the path of avadhuta, then avadhuta could be brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi. Avadhuta can be brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra. He could be Hindu, Muslim, Christian, anyone. Because avadhutas do not fall in the purview of these varnashrama vyavastha. Therefore, vidvastha ashesha vidinishedhoham. Now none of these rules and regulations, do's and don'ts apply on me. समुदस्थ आश्रमितोहम प्रवितित सुखपूर्ण संविद संविद एव अहम इन दिस मैनर समुदित आई एम एक्सट्रीमली ब्लिसफुल एंड आई हैव नो ऑब्लिगेशंस ऑफ एनी काइंड एज लॉन्ग एज देयर आर ऑब्लिगेशंस वी आर बाउंड एंड हाउ दिस ऑब्लिगेशंस कम बिकॉज वी लेबल अवर सेल्फ दैट आई एम समबडी If you are somebody, you have obligation. If you are nobody, you have no obligation. So what is the spiritual practice? Practice being nobody. As a nobody, you sit before the Lord. You are in meditation. You are not doing meditation. But when you start doing meditation, you become a meditator. And when you become a meditator, you suffer silently. These congregational meditations normally are of this type. They'll be closing the eyes and the lights and suffer silently. And when their meditation class is over, then they say, hey, how it was? Oh, it was awful or no, awesome. See, I am in poor English. Friends, that is not. Therefore, further, I have no obligations of any kind because I am this infinite bliss, uncreated. We all know only that happiness or that bliss which is in relation to something. If you wanted a cup of tea in the morning, you are disturbed. I should get a cup of tea in the morning, see, then thereafter such a lovely meditation, tea meditation. No, the Zen masters, they practice tea meditation. Every Zen master got a kettle, a cup of, you know, and a tea leaf, and they keep on sitting with tea meditation. Like 20 tea. And if I do not get, I am extremely disturbed. The moment I get, aha, ab meditation mein maja aayega. Pakode hai ki? So we know only that bliss or happiness which is opposed to the misery. The absolute bliss we don't know. Second thing, the happiness that we know is when our desires are fulfilled. You just see, in your own life, when you were married and in that marriage your photographs were taken, see that photograph and the expressions on the face of both of them. And now you don't want to look. What is the reason? Because that was the happiness of imagination. Now this is the experience of reality. So we know only that happiness which is only fulfillment of desires or in relation to the miseries. But this happiness is not the one which is because of anything. The causeless happiness. When somebody is happy, he asks, "Hey Guptaji, what's wrong with you? Why you are happy?" Because normally Guptajis are miserable. You know this Gupta word I told you, how it came? My friend, this happened in Jhumke Wali Bareli, 8 years before. I was going somewhere and there was a tea stall below a tree. So we went and having a cup of tea. So on a bench, center, there was this chessboard. And both sides, some people were sitting. One person playing and 10 people advising. Both sides. So this one side person was telling, "Are Gupta, ghode ko chala. Tum to haathi ko laga." And thus this fellow won. Then he said, "Hey yaar, who are you? Who told? Maine bataya, I am there. But how do you know that my name is Gupta?" He said, "Har ek bevakoof ko main Gupta hi keh raha." That day I was so happy. I found out. Except those Guptas who have come here. Because I had to survive. Dear friends, this happiness is uncreated. Because it is uncreated, it is independent. Because it is uncreated, independent, it can never be lost. It can never be improved. Therefore, continuing further, sakshi anapekshoham nijamahimni samstaha aham achaloham ajaroham avyayoham paksha vipakshadi bheda viduroham. These are the words for us to understand. We have to see, we don't have to see in others how far or how long this man has gone. So first, sakshi anapekshoham. See, more than sakshi, try this word. Sakshi means what? Witness. Witness has his attention on what is being witnessed. So this witness is having his legs in two bows. One himself, other the one. Better than this, try this. Be indifferent. When we are indifferent, our attention is not at all on anything else. How could we be indifferent as you are now? You may go on telling you are Brahmana. Remain indifferent. The more you start living indifferent, you are naturally withdrawn from the world. When you are sakshi, you are watching the world. Body I am not. And then if you are not body, why are you worried? Don't know what, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. One young boy came and asked me, "Swamiji, I have understood this, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. But people don't understand that I understood." You could laugh, what could I do? So, I told him, what is your understanding? He said, my understanding is, this body, for example, your body. Your body, I am not, I have understood. Hey, Baba, that is the story. The body which I am thinking, this body I am, that body I am not. Oh, I thought, this body I am not, that body I am not. Secrets. Instead of getting lost in this witness, try, remain independent. Everything in this world. This is the ultimate message of Bhagavan Sri Krishna in Bhagavat Mahapurana, in Uddhava Gita. Give it a try. Remain indifferent. When we remain indifferent, we do not give a status of reality to that. How we remain indifferent? Like the statues are indifferent to the birds. The other day we are coming from somewhere, and I don't know whose statue is there, and there is that man is standing in the statue and holding a stick in his hand. That very time, one crow came inside. So I was thinking, he was looking at that. Whether the crow is sitting on the head and doing, it makes no difference to that statue, is it not? In the same manner. Nothing in this world should ever make any difference to us. How is this possible? Only when you remain as nobody. Like in deep sleep, we are nobody, it makes no difference. To us as well as to the world. Therefore, Sakshi Anapekshoham, the second Anapekshoham, living at a zero expectation level. See? About this, I'll tell you one simple example and technique, how it is possible. There was one girl who was supposed to come with me to Uganda. I went many years before. So I said, get your passport made. But Swamiji, I don't know. So there was one Mahatma. He said, Swamiji, don't worry, I'll get it done for her. I said, no, hang around him. Every day that man made her go to his office. Oh, today I have forgotten. Oh, I have got some other room. I have got some meeting. 3-4 days, 1 week. Every day made her come and go, come and go. Then she came. How many? That fellow is a useless one. He called me and he does nothing. I said, look here. First of all, first thing. Second thing. Tell me what right you or we have on him. You have no right. The day you write off your rights, you will be happiest in this world. And if we don't write off our rights, then our rights will be performed right away while we are still alive. Write the proper spellings of the rights. No rights on anything. Therefore, nirapekshoham, nijamahim ni samsthitoham, because I am abiding in my own glory. Here, I remember Swami Khandanji, this particular statement, it has really touched. This happened in Bombay. When we went to tell him, Swamiji, we will come and pick you up for that function. He said, don't worry, you don't have to come, I will come on my own. If you come, I am not going to become big. If you don't come, I am not going to become small. What I am, I know. But for us, respect is respect. Honor. Protocol. We are called, but we are not. Please, give up all these wrong notions. निज महिमनी हम सो हम इफ समबडी टेल्स अस यू आर गुड देयरफॉर वी आर गुड नो वी डोंट रिक्वायर एनीबडी सर्टिफिकेशन सो निज महिमनी अबाइडिंग इन माय ओन ग्लोरी ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट एग्जिस्टेंस एंड अचल ओहम And therefore, I don't get influenced by anything in this world. Achala form. This is what Bhagavad Gita defines God realization. God realization is not some kind of things happening inside, or you are seeing different colors, or you are hearing different music. That is not. It is all at the level of prakriti. Or else, you know, when I went, I saw a divine angel came and caught hold of me and took me somewhere. And when I opened my eyes, I was in the bathroom. Don't get carried away by this. That is not spiritual. Similarly, many people talk about I get vibrations. When I went to that particular temple, there was such great vibration. I said, really? I also got vibration. How? Where the phone in my pocket? Vibration mode. These are all cartoons. Don't get carried away. He said, nothing to do with spirituality. Therefore, achaloham. Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, abidance in the self or merging in the absolute is indicated by only two things. Number one, Shitoshna Sukadukhechu Jitatmana. May any kind of good or bad experiences come in our life, the equanimity of our mind is never corrupted. Under all conditions, the mind is at peace. Therefore, you see, those who are abiding in the truth, according to the path of knowledge or according to the path of devotion, both of them. Man who is abiding in the knowledge or devotion, they never curse anybody. Yogis, tapasvis, they curse. Because they are still living at the relative level. Their foundation is Sankhya. And Sankhya tells, there is one soul per head. And therefore, when you go to such Mahatmas, you see, people are living in fear complex there. Why? If you say something, you will kill. Is that spiritual life? Because they are still holding on to the relative. Therefore, any kind of experience come. This great master is equanimous. Then we are abiding in the truth. And the second is manapamanayoho prashantasya. Whether honor or dishonor, it makes no difference. This is what is called here achaloham. Ajaroham avyayoham ajaraha. I am not a Buddha. When the age grows, one tries to assert, you know, Swamiji, I don't feel I am old. You cannot feel because feelings are in the mind. Mind is never influenced by time. See, it is the body which is influenced by time. Because what is the time? Time is the baby of the mind. How can it get influenced? Therefore, here when we said ajaroham, meaning I am beyond the limitations of this gross body. Then these two things, again and again I repeat. Like on the airport, they repeat one announcement 10 times. This is the last and the final call. And everything is the last and the final call. So from the first call itself they start. Therefore, this is the last and the final time I will tell you. Only two things, very simple things. One, our spiritual practice should be aimed at getting freedom from body identification. See? Now, what is the meaning of this statement? You work on that. That is spiritual life. We like our spirituality or religious practices like a mechanical drill. Maya se techan. There was one recruit, he was being trained. So the officer was telling the whole lot. Left turn, right turn, about turn, and this one was in this time, not moving. And when he found out this one is not moving, he scolded him. Why don't you move? When we tell left and right and about turn. He said, you are confused, you tell finally this turn. Sometimes you tell left turn, sometimes you say right turn. Which is the turn you want? Therefore, ajaroham, unconditioned by the gross form. That is our essence. The first spiritual practice, freedom from body identity. And when the freedom from body identification happens, then the secondary eyes are dissolved. The secondary eyes are the relations. The secondary eyes are the possessions. Therefore, ajaroham means, or if you want to practice this experience, possessions and relations should not bother us. If we have to write our own lives, autobiography of a Dumbo. What is the autobiography? Only two things, possession and relations. Therefore, first spiritual practice, freedom from body identity. Then the second stage, unless the first is done, second will not begin. Like, you know, many people start funny way. Swamiji, I want to practice Oham Koham. What sadhana should be done? Soham Soham. And then their sadhana begins. Soham 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 Soham. And that Soham goes so much in their deep head that they name their child Soham Haja. And that soham goes. So, the second one is freedom from the notion of jiva. So, who am I? This question is valid only for those who have accepted in principle to be someone other than the body. When we have accepted ourselves to be the body, this question is redundant. It has no meaning. As a body, we know who we are. This question cannot come. Question will come. Who was a dreamer? That question will come. Who was a dreamer? See, one story I am reading. One Guru Maharaj got up in the morning and started crying. So, the disciples said, Guru Maharaj, you are crying, what happened? Oh, my dear disciples, I had a very bad dream. But you only told us dreams are illusions, that is in the class, but I had a very bad dream. What was the dream? I was a butterfly. Never mind, it was dream anyway. Forget about it. Take a cup of tea. No. Let me complete. My question is whether your guru was dreaming that I am a butterfly or the butterfly is dreaming that I am a guru. See, friends. Therefore, unless we accept ourselves to be someone other than the body, who am I? Inquiry cannot be initiated. Therefore, ajaroham, get out of the body identification. This is what has happened. And therefore, avyayoham, I cannot be negated. How it is? Be very attentive. Neither the absolute reality can be negated, nor the jiva can be negated. Absolute reality cannot be negated because it is beyond the scope of time, space, etc. And the relative reality also cannot be negated because it is only appearance. It doesn't exist. It is something like in a glass of water, there is, let us say, a reflection of the moon. Now that water is not able to contaminate the moon and also the reflection of the moon in the water. The original moon is not contaminated by the water because it is far away. There is nothing to do, independent. And the reflection in the water is also not contaminated because the reflection is merely an appearance. It doesn't exist. Therefore, avyayoham. This understanding is called as avoidance in the process. And paksha vipakshadi bheda vidroham. And therefore, I am beyond all these. Paksha vipaksha. This way is right, that way is right. I am the follower of devotion. I am the follower of compulsion. No. There is no party to which I belong. See, friends. Like, you know, the politicians. They are loyal to their party, not to the nation. They can bargain the nation for the benefit of the party. In the same manner, those who get lost in the organizational spirituality, they are more concerned about the organization, not about the spiritual path or realization of the truth. See, friends. Therefore, hold on to the truth and truth alone. See, once I went somewhere and during my talk, I must have mentioned Shirdi Sai Baba, Sati Sai Baba, or Ganesh Puri Sitananda Baba, Osho, so many times. After my lecture was over, do you believe in Osho also? I said, sir, I believe in you also. Why bring Osho? I believe in you. You believe in me? I said, yes. Because when you don't know, you have to believe. When you know, you don't have to believe. Therefore, paksha vipakshadi bheda vidroham. So, therefore, biasness on account of any criteria doesn't apply to me. This is how it happens, you know, for many seekers. One girl asked me this question. Swamiji, in my childhood, whole life we were all the Rama Bhakta. Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram, Jai Sri Ram. Now I have come to Gujarat. And here, yes. So I am confused where I am standing before Krishna. In my mind and mouth, it comes to Jai Sri Ram. Now what will happen? I say, to whom? To whom what will happen? Our question is also wrong. I said, you keep on saying Jai Sri Ram. He will get confused. Ram Jai Sri Ram. It makes no difference, friends. But when we are not abiding in the truth, then we are all the time frustrated about this thing. If one person asks me, you don't do Ekadashi? I said, no. Why? Because I do Panchadashi. Ordinary people do Ekadasha, Panchadasha. No doubt can ever disturb you thereafter. Avabodhaikara soham मोक्षानंदैक सिंधुरेवाहम सूक्ष्मोहम अक्षरोहम विगलित गुण जाल केवलात्माहम। अवबोधैक रसोहम, अवबोध मीन्स एक्सपीरियंस। आई एम द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ इमैक्युलेट बीइंग। रस ही अटेंडिव, रस मीन्स दैट वेयर देयर इज नो सीड। सच्चिदानंद घन, यू नो वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स गिवन इन द राइटिंग ऑफ द ग्रेट मास्टर, सच्चिदानंद कंदाय जगतं कुरहेतवे सदोदिताय पूर्णाय नमो नंताय विष्णवे। इन द फर्स्ट प्रेयर दिस इज सेड, सच्चिदानंद कंद, कंदम इज अ ट्यूबर, लाइक पोटैटो इज अ कंद ट्यूबर। इन अ पोटैटो यू कैनॉट सी अ सीड वेयर इट इज, लाइक यू कैन सी इन मैंगो देयर इज अ सीड। So if we have to plant potato, we don't get the seeds anywhere, you state a little bit and it grows. Because the seed is included in the tube. It is all permeating. In the same manner, here, avabodhaika rasoham, rasa means that where there is no seed. Seed means cause. I am the causeless experience of just being. In other words, I am the experiencer, not of anything. What we all know is experience of joy, experience of misery, experience of achievement, experience of failure, experience of marriage, experience of frustration. It is not of the of. Experience only. Therefore, avabodhaika rasoham mokshanandaika sindhurevaham. I am the ocean of bliss of liberation. You know, it is the thoughts only which make us happy or miserable. If we have to think, why not think that I am happy? Because only of the thoughts only, I am very unhappy. Why? I could not get married. As a married fellow, you are lucky man, you are not married. Then both of them compete with each other. Either you are more miserable or I am so happy. Just give me a try. Insist. And you are happy, insist. If you go to Britain, British people have got a very funny expression. No Briton will ever say that I am happy. I say, how are you? Not bad. I am happy. Can you be sharam aati hai? How can I say I am happy? I am miserable and uncomfortable because everybody is there. No. Insist. Insist. Therefore, here, moksha ananda eka sindhurevaham. I am the ocean of blissful liberation. Even if you don't understand, doesn't matter. If you understand, then you start teaching others. When the knowledge becomes experience, the speech is suspended. Because this experience cannot be put in words. Then there is only a blabbering or a language of contradictions. Scriptures and Mahatmas give an example. They say, if somebody is dumb, he cannot talk. एंड यू गिव हिम सम स्वीट मीट, रसगुल्ला एंड आस्क हिम, हे हाउ इज इट, ही हैज टेस्टेड बट ही कांट टॉक, सो व्हाट डू यू से? Now we have to understand what he means. He can't say. Thereafter you give him something namkeen, pakodas, mirchi wala pakoda. Then he eats. How it is? The same expression. He has no language to express his experience. And therefore, the wise people talk to him. The otherwise people only talk. Therefore, those who are chatterboxes, keep away from them. Protect yourself. You are not in this world to improve the world. It is not our creation. If somebody is suffering, don't stop him from suffering. Why? Everybody has got a right to be miserable. We belong to the democracy. Gastu. This I learned from a taxi driver. One of my friends told me, Swamiji, I am taking the car parallel. Tell that taxi fellow, that door is open, he may fall down. So he ordered, I had to do that. So I said, hey Mahatma ji, darwaja khula hai, band karo. आपको क्या लेना है? मैं खुला रहूंगा. वेरी ट्रू दैट दे ऑनवर्ड्स. दिस इज हाउ भगवान दत्तात्रेय हैज गॉट 2 dozen गुरु, आई हैव गॉट मिलियंस. डोंट गेट इन्वॉल्व इन दिस, नो नीड. सूक्ष्मोहम अक्षरोहम. सूक्ष्म मीन्स दैट he attend you. Sukshma means that which does not have any attribute. Shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, they are absent in the mind. Mind doesn't have sound, mind doesn't have form, mind doesn't have smell, mind doesn't have touch, mind doesn't have taste. Therefore, mind is sukshma, subtler than the sense organs as well as the sense objects. Subtler than the mind is the conscious principle, which is expressing as a mind through the body. The consciousness is subtler than the mind, because in the mind there could be thoughts, in the consciousness even thoughts are not there. Sukshma. When this understanding happens, you will not have any kind of meditation. Sit inside, and then in your heart there is Paramatma. So then you go on inside. Will get nikal gaya. No. When we are sukshma, discard all those attributes, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. What is that experience? Then discard all the thoughts. What is that experience? In this experience, body identification and the mind limitations disappear. When the body identification and the mind limitations disappear, then there is neither any effort nor any tiredness. Because efforts and tiredness belong to the body or the mind, not to the self. Therefore, sukhmoham aksharoham. Aksharaha, the one which is not subjected to any loss, ever the same. We cannot have the experience that we have ever changed. Nobody can have that experience. That this unchanging, eternal presence is my essence. Absarvaham vigalita guna jala kevalatmaham. Vigalita guna jala. See, this word has come again and again. Galita disorder. Guna jala, the three gunas of the prakritis, sattva, rajas, tamas. See, this prakriti, prakriti, and you see, don't get lost too much. These people who are following the yoga and meditation, they are lost only in prakriti. And therefore, they talk about concentration. Never, never practice concentration. And to teach concentration, they teach you. Do the trataka. One candle is kept there, is lit, and they look at it. You go away from yourself. And eyes of such people are frightening. You don't feel love in their eyes. There is no death. The best eyes in the whole world, if you want to see, see the eyes of Bhagavan Brahmana Maharshi. Even in the picture, they are so deep. There is no fact. Because here the teacher says, Vigal is the guna jala. They are no more getting lost in the Prakriti's three gunas. Prakriti is that where Vikriti is natural. So don't stop it. Let it happen. Who cares? Spiritual practice is remaining in awareness and not in concentration camps or Hitler. See, friends, but we get so much involved and then concentrate on breathing. No, relax. And when we remain in awareness, the words, we concentrate through mind on others, and in awareness, it is self-awareness. We are aware of our own being. This is what Jai Krishnamurti used to say, objectless awareness. In awareness, if objectivity is introduced, it is mind. When the objectivity is deleted from the mind, it is awareness. Therefore, vigal is a guna jala. Therefore, it is nothing like that, you know, sattva guna is better, raja guna is bad, or tamo guna is useless. No, this is very funny thing goes in the heads of the people. I am not like other people. Lazy, tamo guna. Angry, raja guna. I am the sattva guna, dambo. Every guna is required for life. If you cannot invoke tamoguna, you cannot go to sleep. If you cannot stop the tamoguna by invocation of the rajoguna, you will sleep even in the satsang. And if you cannot transcend the rajoguna, you cannot understand what is being said. All the three gunas are essential for life. There is nothing like good and bad. But how much we got, you know, I am so lazy, I am so, let it be, relax. See? Therefore, friends, vigal is the guna jala, kevala atma aham. I am this kevala atma. If you are a Bengali, kevala atma. Atma which is coming to you through kevala. One person I came to know, one Bengali friend asked me many years ago. My talks were taken by somebody on a those VHS. And every local area they used to have the cable network. This person was a Bengali. He said, Swamiji, if you can give me your dogs, I can put on the table. Okay. And then, Swamiji, you are on cable? Yes. But I don't know your name. I said, cable Ananda. Oh, you are cable Ananda. He used to call me cable Ananda. The one who comes on the cable is cable Ananda. Kevala means that experience where the three kinds of differences are not present. First kind of difference is the vijatiya bheda. Vijatiya means the jati doesn't mean class. That is a political definition for getting votes. That is not the meaning. Jati means form. Manushya jati, pashu jati, vanaspati jati. So, the animals are different from the plants. This is vijatiya bheda. Then sajatiya bheda, all are animals, but some are cows, some are buffaloes, some are snakes, etc. Sajatiya bheda. The third is the swagata bheda. In one specimen, there are differences. Head is not the tongue is not the legs are not the stomach, the differences. So, that where sajatiya, vijatiya, swagata, bheda is totally and completely absent. That is my essentialness.